It's 2019, and yes, you can still catch the plague. Between 2000 and 2009, there were more than 21,000 diagnosed cases of the plague worldwide. But despite its centuries-long horrifying history, the scariest part of the plague today is its name. In fact, in the grand scheme of today's infectious diseases, the plague is by far one of the least likely microbes for the average person to pick up, even if they travel the world. So why are headlines popping up all over the internet about this historic disease? And how is it even still around? To understand that, we'll need to look at what exactly the plague is and how it's killed so many. There have been three major outbreaks of the plague throughout history. The first was the plague of Justinian, which began in 541 AD. Later on, the Black Death killed half of all people in Europe in the 1340s and 50s, making it arguably the most infamous outbreak. But it wasn't until the modern plague, which started in China in the 1860s, that scientists were able to identify Yersinia pestis, the bacterium behind it all. They found out that it spread to humans mostly via fleas. Essentially, the fleas fed on infected rodents like rats, squirrels, or mice, which turned the tiny insects into carriers. When their rodent hosts died, the fleas looked for the next closest living species to feed on, humans. There are three forms of the plague that humans get. All of them can cause a fever, chills, and general discomfort or pain, but from there, they can vary. Bubonic, the disease's most notorious form, can cause extremely swollen and bulb-like lymph nodes in the armpits and groin. Septicemic plague can attack a person's blood and tissue, and even turn their hands and feet black, a sure sign that you should see a doctor. But pneumonic plague is the most infectious form. It affects the lungs, feels like pneumonia, and spreads through the air via cough droplets. In all three forms, fever and other symptoms escalate rapidly, which distinguishes the plague from other maladies. Before the discovery of antibiotics, the plague killed two-thirds of everyone it infected, especially the elderly or people who were already sick. And today, if untreated, it still kills 50 to 60% of all of its victims. But if caught early and treated with antibiotics, that number goes way down. Here's what you should know about the plague today. The majority of plague diagnoses in the past century were in sub-Saharan Africa and Madagascar. But in the US, the disease is found primarily in New Mexico. The rural area there is filled with prairie dogs, and they are particularly prone to catching the bacterium. The plague wipes out 95 to 99% of affected populations. And when those prairie dogs die, the infected fleas hitch a ride on whatever they can find to get to another food source. It would be impossible to eliminate every infected rodent and animal the fleas come into contact with, which is how the plague still hangs on today. Modern medicine, pest control, and generally better sanitation have all made the plague much less of a threat to humanity. If you live in a plague-prone region, make sure to treat your pets with flea medication and don't let them roam free. If you're a hunter in rural areas, make sure you cook your meat thoroughly and definitely stay up to date on the latest public health campaigns. If you don't live in areas where the plague has been identified, it's incredibly unlikely that you'll be infected. Regardless, remember that despite its name, the plague can easily be treated with antibiotics. Recognizing the symptoms and seeking proper treatment is key.